Hi, welcome back to this video. So just a few days back, I saw a video of Swami Turiyananda. He said something which goes along these lines. I'm paraphrasing, of course. Do not get attached or attach yourself to anything or anyone except God. This was an amazing statement. When I went through this video, when I saw this statement, I was like, wow. So beautifully said. When you begin to realize who God is, when you discover God, and when you begin to experience God, you will naturally find that everything that this external world offers isn't really fulfilling. We have been behind materialistic things like money, like relationships, like joy, happiness, peace, everything. We used to go outside and we used to search for it. Now, as we begin to realize God, realize ourselves, these things no longer fulfill us. We are quite content in the present moment. The experience of God can happen only in the present moment. And living in this present moment, it is so blissful, added to the experience of God. The only true thing or a person or whatever it is, the only truth that exists is God. Nothing else is true. It is all a part of the illusion, Maya. Who we are at the core level is the truth alone. What we think we are, what we think we have, what we think we have experienced, none of it is true. The only reason or the only thing that causes us to have an experience or causes us to have something or brings or let me put it this way. The only element that brings certain things into our life, and this thing can be anything. It can be an experience, it can be a physical thing, is our beliefs. Our beliefs are creating our reality every single moment. When we remove our beliefs, when we let go of the beliefs, of every single belief about who we are, about this world, about everything, you will reach back to your original state, which is nothing but energy or nothingness. We are nothingness ourselves. We do not have a form, nor we can have a form. So our form, which we perceive ourselves to be, is a part of the illusion. Anything that you can take, let's say you have a car, you are so attached to the car, you've worked so hard. I mean, it is a really appreciable thing. You've dreamt of having it, you've worked so hard, you've bought it, and now that you're enjoying it, that is all fine, that is perfectly fine. But the moment you attach yourself to it, is the moment when danger starts. Same applies to anything. Same applies to the people around you. Same applies to your business or job or anything that is part of the outer world. Even your body. Swami Turiyananda has beautifully said this. Attach yourself to God, God alone. God will not fool you or cheat you or let you down. The only thing that can let you down is your own belief, but you end up blaming God. When you realize God, when you experience God, and when you fully trust in God, you develop so much love for God. This love can turn into an attachment for God and God alone. If it is any other person, this love has to stop at love itself. You can love a person, you can really love a person, you can be so close to them, you can do all that. But you're putting yourself in soup if you're getting attached to that person. But God is different. God is our true nature. In fact, we can go in depth on who God is. It is nothing but us. Anyone who has transcended this illusion of space and time is a God. And anyone who has done that because they have let go of their beliefs. They have questioned everything, each and everything, every small thing around them. And they realized that none of this is true. Everything is illusory. Adi Shankara went about preaching about the reality of the universe at a very young age. Throughout, he traveled across the length and breadth of India, and he was one of the most prominent saints in this later part of post 1 AD. No, he has written this composition called Bhaja Govindam, in which he says, it's a very beautiful composition, and it has been sung really well by M.S. Subbalakshmi. Now, one part of the song goes about like this. Nagi nagi rakshati dukrin jarane. I think I'm telling it right, or I don't know. I hope I would have told it right. Nahi nahi rakshati. Raksha means protection. Nahi means no. What he tells is that nahi nahi rakshati, meaning there is no protection. Dukrin charane, meaning the grammatical knowledge. What is grammatical knowledge? Basically, he says that this grammatical knowledge will not protect you. Now we need to go in depth on what this grammatical knowledge means. It is the knowledge of the outside world, the external world. Now, what is the real significance of you learning algebra or calculus or whatever it is in your school or college? Or for that matter, even in your job, you may learn a lot of things. But that helps you only for your survival. Now, this is grammatical knowledge. Let's say, for example, for understanding, let's say algebra is the grammatical knowledge. So when Adi Shankara says grammatical knowledge will not protect you, he is saying algebra will not protect you. What he means is that he is not looking at you as this body, as this person who you think you are. He is looking at you at the soul level, at the higher self or God level. He says that this knowledge of algebra is not going to help you. For you are not this body, you are this God, a potential God. But what we end up is straining ourselves to acquire this grammatical knowledge and being again and again subscribing to the illusion. Well, this shouldn't be misunderstood that you shouldn't gain such knowledge. This grammatical knowledge is definitely going to help you. It's going to survive. It's going to make you. It's going to help you in surviving. But our duty is not to survive. Everyone survives. Everyone, I mean, everything, a dog survives, a snake survives, a lion survives, a plant survives. Everything that is there on this planet Earth survives. Then what is the difference of we being born as a human? This form, this body, this incarnation of a human is said to be the only incarnation where we can realize our true self. There are examples from the scriptures where even animals attained godhood, but those have a long story behind them. Those have a really spiritual long story behind them. So our only chance to realize ourselves is in this incarnation. Are we going to miss this chance? Are we going to let this slip away from our hands? Are we going to waste this lifetime chasing insignificant things, feeling insignificant, so stressed up for nothing, and end up dying without realizing ourselves? Are we? Isn't that so? I feel so pity for ourselves. This is such a big gift for we being born as humans. We have spent millions of years evolving through different species, and finally we have this chance of reaching our home, to getting to where we are forever. I want you to think about this. I want you to really take the time, maybe play this video again and again, and start questioning yourself and start really thinking about this. You have this tremendous opportunity with you right now. You have the choice to either seek the truth or keep chasing insignificant things. If you already started seeking the truth, then great, you are on the right track. But if you have not, then I hope this video is kind of a wake-up call for you. It is such a stupid thing to do, to let this life pass away doing things that are of no use. Adi Shankara again says in a different line of the same composition, he says, samprapte sannihite kale. This is the line just before the line which we saw before. The whole thing goes like this: samprapte sannihite kale nahi nahi rakshati tukrin charane. Samprapte sannihite kale. Sannihite kale, meaning the last few days. Samprapte sannihite kale means gain the real happiness at least in your last few days. He knows, and he says this. See, he literally says this. He is telling to all of us, hey, see, look, you've spent your entire life chasing things that are insignificant, and you're searching happiness that are so temporary. So why don't you search for real happiness at least in the last few days? And the next line he goes about saying, this grammatical knowledge of yours is not going to save you. Now in the same composition, this is such a beautiful composition. I highly encourage you to go and listen to this composition. It's there on YouTube or online. You can find it very easily. And more importantly, look at its meaning. There's no point in just listening to it. So another line of this composition, he says, moodajanihi or moodajahihi janatama krishna. I hope I'm telling it right, because I've not mugged it up. I've listened to it for quite some time, and my intent is to not to give you a perfect perfect recitation. My intent is to convey the meaning and to inspire you to go and look at the real recitation so that you can actually learn. Moodajahi janatama trishnam. Now this, with this statement, he goes a little abusive. He says, Moodajahi, meaning, you foolish person. Oh, foolish one. He's looking at us and saying, hey, foolish, hey, you fool. Look at Krishna. Sing about Krishna. When he says Krishna, he's talking about God. His intent is not to, of course, he was a Hindu and he was preaching to a land where there were, it was inhabited by Hindus. But his intent was to ask us to search for God. Oh foolish one, search and praise and sing the glory of God. What are you doing? So I hope this video has somewhat inspired you to look beyond the survival and the accumulation mode and to look and to start searching for the truth, the true you, the God. This is what you are here for actually. Now this is again a huge topic. We can go on talking for hours and hours about how we came here, about how we incarnated, about how we lost all our memories. But we're not gonna do that in this video. So again, I just mentioned the word accumulation, and Adi Shankara, in the same composition, in a different line, talks about accumulation. I am not able to recollect that line at the moment, but again, I encourage you to go and look at the actual recitation. So just summing up, so we saw about Swami Turiyananda, about his beautiful saying of we having to attach to God. And then we saw as to why we should do that, about how our incarnation, about how this lifetime of ours is so precious, and why we shouldn't waste this time in surviving and accumulating, and why we should spend this time in actually searching for the truth. We also saw a lot of lines from Bhaja Govindam of Swami Adi Shankara. So I hope this video has been of use to you. Do like this video and let me know in the comment section as to what you think about it. Also do share it among the people who you think will benefit out of this video. And I wish you all the best in your truth-seeking journey. Thank you and see you soon.